Welcome everyone to our next episode of Sustainable Atmanirbharta. So this is our episode number 4 and it is Now I Understand. Do you know what do I understand now and what do I want you to understand as well? No? Let me tell you what I understood and what I would like you to understand through a story. So there was once a lady named Rita. Rita was a working woman and she was married, and her husband was very supportive and he was also working in some multinational company. So they both used to come back home by around 8 p.m. Then she used to cook dinner, he used to help her with the dishes and everything, and then they used to have dinner together. And after that, they used to watch TV and then go to sleep so that they can wake up early in the morning and start with their routine of going to office and things like that. But there was a huge problem in that routine, the night routine when they used to sleep. The disturbance was, and the issue was, that whenever Rita used to get a sound sleep, she used to get some unusual sounds of snoring. And as you can imagine, her husband used to snore, and she always used to get disturbed with the snoring sounds of her husband, and she always used to complain next morning to her husband that, you know what, because you were snoring so loud, I was not able to get proper sleep, so today my whole day will get ruined, I will not be able to focus on the work. Even while I was making the breakfast, I was not able to make it with my entire attention just because you were snoring. And this is how things used to happen, and there was a kind of a tension related to this snoring thing between both of them, Rita and her husband. So days went by. One day there was some issue that happened in Rita's husband's office, because of which Rita's husband started remaining quite tensed. He used to remain stressed out, nervous, tensed, and he was not able to pay proper attention to whatever they used to do earlier. With any work that they used to do together earlier, he was not able to pay his full attention. Rita was also experiencing sleepless nights, just because she was worried about the tension that her husband is facing, about the stress that her husband is having. And a week went by, I guess, and after a week everything sorted out, and her husband was very happy. He came back home and he informed Rita that, you know, everything has been sorted out and I'm extremely happy. Today I'm going to sleep properly, blah blah blah, things like that. And Rita just made a comment on it. Yes, you will sleep properly, but what about me? You snore so much, I don't think that I'm going to sleep properly. To which her husband just gave her a smile, and they went back to sleep. So while they were sleeping, or while they laid down on the bed, Rita just realized that her husband slept, and as usual he was snoring, and there was a difference this time. The difference was, she was actually feeling extremely relaxed when she heard him snoring. It was kind of a lullaby for her, that, you know, she was getting that feeling, oh, thank goodness he's snoring. This means that he's having a peaceful sleep. This means that he is not stressed out. This means that he's relaxed and he is actually sleeping. This will make him fresh when he wakes up in the morning, and he will have good time next day. This was the feeling that she started getting when she heard the snoring of her husband this time. And when she was thinking like this, all of a sudden she paid attention to her thinking. And what she realized is, she realized that now I understand. It's not about the snoring that was bothering me. It was my belief system about the snoring that was bothering me. So this means that I was thinking too much and relating too much the snoring sound with the feeling or with the experience of uneasiness. And that is the reason I used to get uneasy whenever he used to snore. But now when I am thinking it the other way, I am relating the feeling of or the sound of snoring with the experience of relaxed mindset. I am relating it with the peaceful sleep. I have a different kind of feeling. And that night, Rita slept well. She had the soundest sleep that she could have ever had. And when she woke up early in the morning, she narrated the same experience to her husband. And she said, "You know what? I was very happy that you snored yesterday because I was relaxed. Because you were relaxed." So now with this story, I understood that it's not about the problem that gives a problem or that creates a problem. It's about the belief system that I hold in my mind about that problem that makes it a problem, right? So this is what I also would like you all to understand as well, that I understand there may be problems. I understand there may be irritating situations in lives, but if we have a belief system that the situation is irritating, we'll feel irritated, come what may. Trust me, if you have a belief that, okay, this person is making me irritated, you are going to get irritated and irritated and irritated. However, on the other hand, if you just change the belief system and the belief system just gets replaced by, okay, the person may be irritating, but I am sound enough to take care of my mental health, then accordingly, your experience will start changing. From an unpleasant experience, you will start shifting and transforming yourself to the pleasant experience. So now I understand it's not the problem, it's the belief about the problem that makes it a problem. And I would like you all to also understand that it's not the problem. It's the belief about that problem that is giving you the problem. So from now on, whenever you feel the feeling of uneasiness within you, you're not liking that experience or feeling, just take a pause. Just take a pause and write down that what is the belief that you are holding in your mind which is causing this kind of unpleasant experience. And the moment you write it down, automatically you will find that you will find out the constructive belief that you need to hold and believe in your mind to get rid of that problem and situation. It works. Try this down. So what is our next sustainable Atmanirbhar mindset? It's the mindset that now I understand it's not the problem which is creating the problem. It's the belief about the problem that is creating the problem. And the moment I change my belief system about that problem, the problem disappears. Yes, it disappears. So thank you so much for watching once again. Have a great evening.